direct from the McCormick Place Exposition Center, the Auto Channel presents exclusive press pass coverage of the Chicago Auto Show.
On behalf of the Bridgestone Global family of companies, we're thrilled to once again be part of the Chicago Auto Show. For more than a century, the Chicago Auto Show has presented the auto industry's brightest innovations, and today is no exception. I'm excited and proud that Bridgestone Americas has forged ahead to develop technologically as well as environmentally advanced tires that give consumers reliable performance and world-class quality. To help me unveil these two newest additions to the Bridgestone line of tires, I'd like to welcome to the stage Mr. Phil Pacey.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thanks, John. My name's Phil Pacey. I'm the Vice President of Consumer Marketing for Bridgestone Americas, and welcome. Today, when you have the opportunity to visit our booth, you'll have a chance to see our exciting new products, technologies, and new innovations from Bridgestone.
That's right, Phil, and what we really want to focus on today and what we're especially proud of are the two environmentally progressive tires for Bridgestone brand. You know, our commitment to environmental leadership touches every facet of our business, from creating green products in an environmentally responsible way to working with partners to protect lands and waterways. The Bridgestone Group's global One Team, One Planet program includes efforts such as earning international recognition for outstanding environmental building, design, and utilization, to establishing wildlife habitats and education programs. And not the least of which, Phil, is developing tires to improve fuel economy. That's what we're here to talk about today. So without further delay, let me introduce one of these environmentally advanced tires, the Bridgestone Ecopia EP422. Here it is.
Well, last year, right here at the Chicago Auto Show, we rolled out the Ecopia EP100. Today, we introduce the Ecopia EP422 tire, an all-season tire. That's the unique difference between that and the EP100, an all-season tire that's engineered with Bridgestone's patented NanoProtect technology. This technology improves rolling resistance and helps contribute to fuel economy and carbon dioxide reduction. It utilizes post-consumer recycled materials. The EP422 helps consumers reduce their carbon footprint without sacrificing the tire's wet performance and wear. This new tire comes in five sizes with popular fitments including the Toyota Prius, Honda Civic Hybrid, Chevy Malibu, and Nissan Altima.
So Phil, I see this is an all-season tire for cars, but what about those of us who drive light trucks, SUVs, or CUVs? Do we have an environmentally friendly vehicle tire for those vehicles?
We absolutely do. And now I'd like to introduce the Bridgestone Dueler HL 422 Ecopia. And here it is. The Dueler HL 422 Ecopia also is a fuel-efficient tire specifically designed for SUVs and CUV applications. It incorporates Bridgestone's latest and best rolling resistance technology, resulting in better fuel efficiency. With its fuel-saving tread and sidewall compounds, the Dueler HL 422 Ecopia offers Bridgestone's highest level of overall tire performance, including wet handling and stopping ability. This tire also comes in five popular sizes that include fitments such as the Cadillac Escalade Hybrid, the Lexus RX400H, the Ford F-150, and the Toyota Highlander Hybrid.
So it's the Ecopia 422. Phil, is there any significance to the number?
Two good questions. Absolutely there is. 422 happens to be Earth Day. So our Ecopia tires are part of Bridgestone's commitment to produce a greener tire. Please watch.
Thank you.
Well, John, as you know, these two new Ecopia tires are not only good for our planet, they're also good for your pocketbook.
That's right, Phil. In recent testing, the Ecopia EP422 demonstrated a 36% improvement in rolling resistance when compared to a conventional Bridgestone tire, and the Dueler HL 422 Ecopia showed a 42% improvement in rolling resistance compared to a conventional Bridgestone tire. That lower rolling resistance results in a 4% better fuel economy when compared to the conventional tire.
Okay, so John, these fuel economy numbers really can result in savings at the pump. For example, with gasoline averaging $2.70 a gallon, a typical fuel tank being 15 gallons, a driver who fills up their vehicle once a week, well, in a year, that would be about $85 savings in gas, and over a four-year period of time, that would be almost $340 savings with these Ecopia products.
Wow, that's almost enough to cover the cost of the tires themselves. So creating a green tire doesn't mean you have to sacrifice wear, wet performance, or stopping ability. Both of these Ecopia additions to the family will provide fuel economy improvements and a lower carbon footprint. But they're also rugged enough that they come with a 65,000-mile treadwear warranty. In addition, both tires come with our exclusive buy-and-try warranty. You can drive on these tires for 30 days, and if you're not completely satisfied, you can bring them back.
Well, in addition, as we take a closer look at our two newest members of the Bridgestone brand family, I invite you to come to our booth and check out some new Firestone tires that continue to build on our tradition of innovation and the heritage of quality products that consumers have trusted for almost 110 years.
And the four new Firestone tires we're introducing this year will cover every segment of the market. So whether you drive a car, an SUV, CUV, or truck, we have a new Firestone tire for you.
That's right. And information and photos of the new Ecopia products, as well as the new Firestone products unveiled here today at the Chicago Auto Show, will be available in our media kits that you can pick up in our booth later on. We hope that you'll join us over there for lunch right after an exciting Delta Wing announcement.
That's right, Phil. We're excited now to pass the stage to Delta Wing for a very special presentation. We're also proud that Firestone is the official tire of the iZod IndyCar series, as well as Firestone Indy Lights. And we're as eager as anyone to see the concept car that Delta Wing will unveil here today. It's a car that may revolutionize open-wheel racing.
First of all, I'd like to express our thanks and appreciation to Bridgestone Americas for inviting us to participate with them at the automobile show. Secondly, I'd like to thank all of those in the Indy racing community who have given their support to Delta Wing based on its potential to make our sport once again newsworthy, relevant, and cutting edge. My job today is to explain that Delta Wing brings more than a new race car. It is a new concept in doing business in the motor racing industry. We all know that the traditional race car constructor's business model is threatened by the difficulty to control costs, particularly in open categories of racing. On the other hand, the technical stagnation and low margins with the one make formula have caused the reverse effect, but still, for the racing industry, we've suffered accordingly. At the same time, our sport faces where the pressure is on to deliver effective responses to the real economic environmental changes, and the safe option isn't even safe anymore. The truth is, racing has been slow to take up the new challenge. Our solution is to create not only a race car for the future, but also the race car business of tomorrow. We are introducing a platform which provides the core technology, design, and components around which chassis constructors, engine builders, racing teams, automakers, fuel manufacturers, suppliers, and parts suppliers can join together in creating race cars. Our goal is to make it possible for anyone with sufficient capability, including Swift, Dallara, Lola, to participate in the process of advancing auto racing technology with genuine spin-off benefits for the road cars of the future. We will present full details of our open technology business concept in the near future. The Greek letter Delta, of course, stands for change, and our name is emblematic of our commitment to revolutionizing both the technology and the business of motor racing. This is the most important and exciting project of my 40 years involvement in racing, and I look forward to working with the entire racing and automotive industry to make this a reality. And now I'd like to hand over to our Chief Technology Officer, Ben Bowlby, the visionary force behind Delta Wing.
Thanks, Dan. And thanks to you all for being here today. A year ago, Chip Ganassi and I laid out a list of challenges faced by motorsport today and began to work on a concept that could address them while meeting the spirit and intent of the Indy Racing League's chassis objectives for 2012. Innovation is fundamental to top-level racing. The machines must be innovative, intriguing, and newsworthy. From the shape of the car to the powertrain and safety features, we questioned the conventional and explored the possible. The result is an attempt to meet the demands for efficiency and sustainability that are already reshaping our world without compromising the sheer speed that is the essence of racing's appeal. The Delta Wing design will easily achieve the level of performance of the current IndyCar. It will do it with half the weight, less than half the aerodynamic drag, half the horsepower, and half the fuel consumption, and all at half the cost. This dramatic efficiency gain has the potential to inspire current race fans, attract new followers, and most important of all, for the future, create a new generation of young enthusiasts. The engine is not a structural element of the Delta Wing chassis. This makes it possible to use a wide variety of fuel-efficient, lightweight powertrains of different types. To encourage innovation and diversity in this area, only the rate of fuel flow to the engine will be controlled. Engine capacity, layout, and RPM will be unrestricted. The goal will be simply to use the given fuel in the most efficient way to make power. The very objective of every automaker's current R&D efforts. The Delta Wing project thus also offers an exciting platform for car manufacturers seeking to showcase their future road car technology. The Delta Wing car will also confront a challenge that has somewhat eluded the motorsport industry for the last two decades. Our shape and aerodynamic concept will allow drivers to run close together on every type of racetrack and promote the kind of battles and overtaking moves demanded by the fans. Finally, Delta Wing will address the economic reality that all racing series face today. We anticipate that being able to sell a complete car, including engine, for approximately $600,000, around half the price of a current generation IndyCar. And as Dan mentioned, we can achieve this cost reduction and bring back the benefits of technological competition at the same time. We are proud to say that the Delta Wing prototype is being designed and built in racing's hometown, Indianapolis, with some of America's most advanced technology and best engineering talent. Since news of this project began to emerge, there has been intense speculation about the Delta Wing concept. How many wheels does it have? Does the car have wings? Will it turn through the hairpin at Long Beach? How fast will it be at Indy? These are just some of the questions we've heard, and once you see it, I know you'll have many more. So I invite you to turn your attention to the Bridgestone America's booth on your left. for the worldwide premiere of our full-scale model. After the unveiling, the Delta Wing team, along with some of the IndyCar owners and drivers, will be happy to discuss with you what we see as the exciting road to the future of IndyCars.
Thanks for watching The Auto Channel. For more press pass coverage of all major automotive events, visit theautochannel.com, the internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive information resource.